The Friday, what you have seen, how to handle the exception handling. Okay. Whenever handle a SOF not found exception, I pass to one simple message. Simple message. Now I want to pass my exception message as a in the form of Java object. My own Java object. Okay. That will go to see now. In the exception class package itself, I'm creating one class called error object. Error object. Okay, error object. Then that error object, I am creating a private error code int error code private error message private then local date and time. Okay, then I'll go to create on constructor public error object error code error message local data. Okay, these are class I designed for a error message. Okay, error object, it has the three attributes. I'm initializing the three attributes value through its constructor. Okay. Now I want to use this error object in my exception cases. Let's see how to do that. What is this? Public class error object means some error. Now I'm going to the my validation class. My validation class here. Just we need to use that particular error object. Error message. Error object equal to error object. Error object. In the constructor, we need to pass the first parameter is a error code. I am saying some error code 101. Then I am taking the error message. That error message coming from resource not found exception class. eh.getMessage. Then I want to take a current date and time. That will tell when that error happened. Local date and time dot now. That's it. Then through this line, I am constructing my error object. That error object I am passing as a response. Instead of ex.getMessage, I am passing now this error object. New return new response entity. In the part of response entity, I am passing error object as a message, response message. Then status code as a not found. Status code as a not found. Okay. Whenever system throws resource not found exception anywhere in the project, that time this class get execute. This class get execute. I am initializing my error object. In that error object, I am passing as a error message through response entity along with status is saying not found. Now we'll see that. Go to controller, customer controller. We'll be using get customer by ID. Okay, I'll start the server now. Yeah, server is started now. What is the port number? Port number is 8080. We don't have any row. Now we're going to try to find one customer that is not available in the database. Let's say 8080, right? Why it's not coming? Say it says customer is not found. ID is 10. Now why it's giving like this error? I need to create a getter setter. I forgot to create getter setter. That's the issue. Jackson, when convert object to JSON, getter setter is mandatory. So now I got my expected error. Now I got an expected error. Okay. 1 minute. I want to do one more testing here. Error object. Let's see. Control. So I forgot to create a getter setter method. Okay, that is a mandatory while converting Java object to JSON. Okay, without that our JSON library cannot perform Java object to JSON. That's the reason it was giving the some other error. Okay, now I got that proper error. Error code is a 101. Error message is a the customer is a not phone for the ID 9. Then current date and time. When this error is happened. Okay, when you look at here in the my validation, I'm simply passing the error object. I'm constructing the error object. In the error object, first parameter I'm passing an error code, second argument is a message, third argument is a current date and time. That error object I'm passing as a error message through the response entity. Now we have a proper error structure. Instead of passing a single message, we have to design our error such a way that should look good, looks good and readable by the client. Okay, then so far we have used the H2 in-memory database, right? H2 in-memory database for a basic CRUD operation, but I have not talk about any apart from the basic CRUD operation. We need to learn a lot. JP is very vast. Okay, JP is very vast. I will going to definitely teach some advanced concept in JPA. How to do with one to one, one to many, many to many. There are various type of relationship. Also, we can see various type of queries. How to perform a queries through JPA. That will going to talk about in separate session. It will be a 1 or 2 session. Okay, now. I want to convert this application as a MySQL. So far it uses a H2 in-memory database. Go to application YAML file. One minute, guys. Now I want to change this configuration to MySQL. Once we change the configuration, the same CRUD operation we can do without doing any code change. Okay. Let's see how to do that now. First, we need to go to MySQL Workbench. Please install the MySQL in your local machine. If anyone don't know how to install MySQL, I have some videos. I will share that video in WhatsApp group. Okay, how to install MySQL? It's actually it's very easy only. But still, if you need, I have a video for that. I'll log in as a root connection. Root is a super user. Okay, I'll log in as a root connection. This is a MySQL workbench, it's a client tool. It's a client tool to access them MySQL database, which we installed in our local machine. Okay, now first of all, I want to create a one database. Okay, you can use this root user, you can use this root user also. Okay, for example, if you want to connect a root user, what you have to do? Username is a root, username is a root, then password is a whatever password you have, that you have to use. That's it. Then we need to use respective MySQL driver cluster. We need to use, that's it. That is the changes we need to do. Then this URL path, username and the password, and the MySQL driver cluster. These three information you have to change if you want to convert any other database, not only MySQL. If you want to convert any other database, this information we need to change. Okay, now I'm going to create user. I don't want to connect to the root user here. I want to connect with the some other user. For that, once you logged in, once you open, this connection is coming, right? Whatever connection we have is coming. If you don't have any connection, it will be a blank. This area is a blank. Okay, you have to create plus. When you say plus, it will create, we can create a new connection. I will show that demo after that. Now I want to log in as a root connection. I'll go to click that root connection box, go to administration. In this administration section, you can see user and privileges. User and privileges, add account. Now I want to create a new user called training admin. Okay, then password is a 123. I keep it simple. Then 123, then apply. It's saying a password is more than one password with 8 character or more. That is not an issue. Okay, it's a warning only. Okay, I created a one user called training admin, and user is a 123. Okay, then go to user and the in the same section, user and the privileges, you can see administrative privileges. Click DBA. If you click that user training hyphen admin having all the access to manipulate the database, then apply. Okay, now through root user, I created a one user called training hyphen admin. I want to use that user in my application. Okay, I'm going to close this connection now. I closed. See, this, each different box connect with a different user. Now I created a training hyphen admin, right? I want to create a one connection for that training user. For that, you have to click the plus icon. Plus icon. The connection name is a training admin connection. I mean training admin connection. Then what is the username? Training admin. Then what is the password? I given 123. Okay, test connection successful, made the MySQL connection able to success. Then okay, once you done that, you can see one more box, training admin connection. Once you click this, it will connect training admin user. Connect the MySQL using training admin user. Then go to schema. Now I want to create a new database. Here I am using testdb, right? I want to, like that, I need to create a one db here for I want to, in the MySQL I want to create a one db. For that, click this icon, training-db. I'm saying training-db, apply. See, a training-db is coming here. Training-db is coming here. As of now, I don't have any table here. As of now, I don't have any table here. I want to use training admin as a user. Through that user, I want to connect training-db in my program. I want to configure this information in our Spring Boot application. Go to that project, just create a in the URL section, just give a path of the MySQL. To access the particular DB, we need to give the path. For that, I'll take the reference of my building system. I forgot the path. See, this is the path we need to use. Just to replace this. Here I want to use training DB. Training DB. JDBC colon MySQL colon localhost 3306 MySQL default port number to access the MySQL. Then from the MySQL server, I want to access one DB call training-DB. Then what is the username password? Username is a training-admin. Then password is a 123. Then we need to give right driver class name here. This is a S3 in-memory database driver, right? These are not correct. We need to give a right driver class name. For that, go to Maven repository. Maven repository. MySQL connector. Maven repository MySQL connector. Search like that. Give you the result. This is a MySQL connector artifact. This library we need to add in our Spring Boot application. This library we need to add. To connect H2, what you have done? To connect H2, here we have added this dependency, right? This dependency providing H2 library, H2 driver class libraries. H2 library and a driver class name through this artifact. I'll going to comment out this. Now I want to use because I am connecting MySQL. Okay, then reload Maven reload project. Okay, here it's giving the error. The dependency diversion is taken care by our Spring Boot dependency management. Spring Boot dependency management, I think it will take care. Okay, it's not giving. Sometime it will give the error. That time we need to remove the version. That will take automatically default version. This time, now this is not giving any error. Leave it as it is. Okay. Okay, now we need to use a right driver file name, a driver class name. Go to billing system, just to copy this driver file, paste it here. Now restart your application. So our starter, when you look at the log, you can see here, Hibernate create table customer. That table is created automatically. Okay, if you want to migrate one DB to another DB, it's so simple in Spring Boot. Just we need to add the artifact, then we need to add the DB URL, username, and the password. Then it's respective driver file name. When you see the database now, here we don't have any table, right? Now one table must created here. Refresh it. You can see customer.
So okay. This every time table will be created when we run the application?
No. It's a very first time when it will create.
Okay.
If not there, it will create.
Okay.
Okay. Here I am starting very first time, right? So it's creating. Now I want to perform the same code operation here. Post method. I don't have a request. We have a custom ID, name, address, fee, right? ID, name, address, fee. Okay. Now I'll go to send a request. Not found. What is the path? I think I have a wrong path. Yeah. API/customers. API/customers. See, customer is created. I got the success response. Okay, I got the success response. I will check the database now. Customer is created. Okay. So it's so simple to configure particular database. Once you that is whatever database you want to connect, just you need to replace the respective configuration here. That's it. Then you need to add the artifact. Spring Boot take care of everything. I'm not changing any coding right here for adding a new customer. It's work as it is. Okay. In the later session, I'm going to take some advanced concept in JPA. Not now, because please comfortable with this particular thing, the basics thing. Once you're comfortable, whatever I'm going to teach in JPA, easily you can understand. Okay. It will be a two session, I think. One for how to do various type of mapping. Various type of mappings, that is various type of relation, one to one, many to many, one to many, many to one. Those things we'll go to see. Then how to perform a query using those relations. That's it. We'll see that in some other session. Now we'll go to focus on some other topics. Okay. Okay, now we'll go to see content negotiation. There's another topic, the content negotiation. Content negotiation, nothing but it's a contract between client and server. It's a contract between client and server. What's happening client and between the client and server? They're exchanging the resource, right? They're exchanging a resource. While exchanging a resource, they are using certain format. They're using certain format. In our case, we're using JSON. Client sending a request in the form of JSON. Server taking that request and manipulating it and sending the response to the client as a JSON format. So this is called as a content negotiation. Okay, so client giving that telling to the server, hey, I can use only JSON format. I cannot use any other format, so I'll always send a request as a JSON. In please accept that JSON request, process it and give the response. Also, please give me as a JSON format, don't give any other format, otherwise I cannot understand saying. So the server is configured in such a way to give a request, to manipulate the request, JSON request, and sending the response as a JSON. Our Spring Boot application now by default able to manipulate JSON request and response. Okay, suddenly there is a new client is coming. That client is having only understand XML format. Only understand XML format. They don't know how to send a JSON request, how to receive the JSON response which is coming from the server. Without informing this information, if I send a request in the form of XML to the server, suddenly throw the error. It will take the data. Oh, this is not my representation. I cannot understand this data. I cannot understand this format of resource. I cannot manipulate. Then it send an error to the server. Yeah, I cannot. I don't know how to use the XML format. Please send the JSON format. It will say. So we need to tell to the before sending the request and response from the client, we need to tell properly to the server, yeah, I am using this type of content format, please adopt that those content. We need to tell to the server configure such a way it able to manipulate those format also, okay, those XML format also. Now I'll going to create a one simple request. 1 minute. In the header, right? I'll go to add one more attribute. Accept application / XML, application / XML. Okay. So here I'll going to create a request as a Suresh. I'm saying K7. Second street. 2000. Let's see what's happening. Here I'm saying accept application XML, content type application JSON. Content type means whatever content you are setting here. That is content type. Accept meaning expecting the XML response. Client expecting the XML as a response. Okay, now I'll sending a request. 406 not acceptable. Server immediately sending the error. 406 now for error code is 406 not acceptable. Data created here. Second record, second sheet. Successfully able to get the receive the request, able to process it. After processing it, at the time of sending request, your client header saying I need only XML format response. You say suddenly server throwing the error. No, I cannot give a response as a XML. I can give only JSON. And it's saying like that. This is the error it's saying. Now a client is saying, no, I need only XML format only. Please do it. It's saying, based on that request, we need to configure our server. Then after configuring, the server is able to send a response, both JSON as well as XML. How to configure now? We'll see that. It's very simple. We don't have to do any much configuration. Go to Maven repository. Jackson XML. Search Maven repository Jackson XML. Click the latest version. Copy it. Paste it here. Then right click Maven reload project. Through this artifact, Spring Boot automatically configure for XML request and response. If once we added this attribute, your application able to configure able to, sorry your Spring Boot application able to manipulate XML request as well as a XML response. Now we need to restart the server. Okay, some problem is coming here, but because of the version maybe it's not a correct version. Better we have to give it to Spring Boot to manage the version. Okay, I will going to remove that version. So it will pick a right version. Yeah, server is started up. Whatever the latest version is, I have copied here, that is not compatible with current Spring Boot version. So it was giving the error while starting the server. After removing the version, Spring Boot dependency management system automatically taking the right version. Okay, so it's not giving any error. I'll go to the postman now. The postman, I'll change the request. So accept equal to XML you have given, right? Let's see what's happening now. See, now I'm able to get the XML as a response. Now our application able to process response as a XML. Okay, whatever request coming, process the request and generate the response of the XML. Okay. Now here I'll go to change XML. Now I want to send a request as XML. But this is a JSON, right? I'll just try to do that. What's happening? See here, since I in header I'm mentioning the XML is giving some error. com.fastxmljson.json parser, JSON parser exception coming, because I am passing a JSON format, because but I am setting an XML, right? XML as a content type. That's the reason server not able to process this just data, because this is a JSON format. Now I want to process as a XML format, right? Just to copy this. Now I'm sending request. So now I'm able to process the request, because I'm sending request as a XML. Also I'm getting response as XML, because here I'm setting content type is XML, accept also XML. So now our server is able to process both JSON as well as XML. Okay, this concept is called as a content negotiation. Okay, now we'll go to see how to manipulate property files from the YAML files effectively in Spring Boot. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.